ugly. Your daughter is ugly. She knows loss intimately, carries whole cities in her belly. As a child, relatives wouldn't hold her, said she was splintered wood, seawater, that she reminded them of the war. On her 15th birthday, you taught her how to tie her hair like rope and smoke it over burning frankincense. You made her gargle rose water, and while she coughed, said, "Ma'anto, girls like you shouldn't smell of lonely or empty." You are her mother. Why did you not warn her? Hold her like a rotting boat. Tell her that men will not love her if she is covered in continents, if her teeth are small colonies, if her stomach is an island, if her thighs are borders. What man wants to lay down and watch the whole world burn from his bedroom? Your daughter's face, a small riot, her hands, a civil war, a refugee camp tucked behind each ear, a body littered entirely with ugly things, but God, doesn't she wear the world well? This poem that I'm going to read next is called The House. Mother says there are locked rooms inside all women, kitchen of lust, bedroom of grief, bathroom of apathy, and sometimes the men, they come with keys, sometimes the men, they come with hammers. Nin sochog lagawaya sochi fa lagahela. I said stop, I said no, and he didn't listen. Perhaps Rihanna has a plan. Perhaps she takes Chris back to hers, only for him to wake up hours later in a bathtub full of ice with a dry mouth looking down at his new, neat procedure. I point to my body and say, oh, this old thing, no, I just slipped it on. Are you gonna eat that? I say to my mother, pointing to my father, who's lying on the dining room table with an apple stuffed in his mouth. The bigger my body is, the more locked rooms there are, the more men come with keys. Anwar didn't push it all the way in. I still think about what he could have opened up inside of me. Basil came and hesitated at the front door for 3 years. Johnny, with the blue eyes, came with a bag of tools he had used on other women. One hairpin, a bottle of bleach, switchblade, and a jar of Vaseline. Yusuf called out God's name through the keyhole. No one answered. Some begged. Some climbed up the side of my body looking for a way in. Some said they were on their way and did not come. Show us on the doll where you were touched, they said. I said I didn't look like a doll, I looked like a house. So they said, show us on the house. I said like this, two fingers in the jam jar. Like this, a rolled up sleeve in the sink. Like this, a hand in the drawer. I should tell you about my first love, who found a trapdoor under my left breast 9 years ago, fell in, and hasn't been seen since. Every now and then I feel something crawling up my thigh. He should probably make himself known. I'd let him out. I hope he hasn't bumped into the others, the pleasant boys from small towns who did bad things and got lost in the maze of my hair. I treat them well enough, a slice of bread if they're good, hummus if they're really, really good, and except for Johnny with the blue eyes, who picked my locks and crawled in, silly boy. Now he's tied to the radiator of my basement. I play music to drown him out. Knock, knock. Who's there? No one. At parties, I point to my body and say, this is where love comes to die. Guys, welcome. Come in. Make yourself at home. Everyone laughs. They think I'm joking. This poem is called The Diet. Lose some weight, he said, I did. Let your hair down, he said, I did. Sit up straight, he said, I did. Don't laugh too much, he said, I did. Sit with your legs closed, I did. Twirl, he said, I did. Bend over, cover your head, squishod, you laugh too much, you talk too much, and now you've lost too much weight. So I ate and ate until I felt sick. I ate everything, can opener, dog food, a DVD player, one bar of soap, a wicker chair, an atlas, my mother's wedding photograph, I swallowed it all. He looked at me, sometimes with disgust, sometimes in awe. I was the animal he had created out of his own insecurity. Then once, while he slept, his perfect mouth almost drawn onto his perfect face, I leaned in and bit him. His blood fizzed. He woke to say, "Close your mouth when you chew." Our men do not belong to us. Even my own father, who left one afternoon, is not mine. My brother is in prison, is not mine. My uncles, they go back home and are shot in the head, are not mine. My cousins are stabbed in the streets of this city for being too or not enough, are not mine. Then the men we try to love say we carry too much loss, wear too much black, are too heavy to be around, much too sad to love. And then they leave and we mourn them too. But our bodies are mine. My body is mine. My good hands are mine. My feelings that glitter when I tip back my head to laugh, mine. My stretch marks that glow under the blue light is mine. My hair in the morning, mine. My face in the mirror, mine. I take back my heart, it's mine. Whatever I choose to love is mine. Whatever I rename, reclaim, redefine, mine. Even when my loneliness grows teeth, mine. I'm going to end with a poem from my collection called Conversations About Home at the Deportation Centre. And I do a lot of work internationally with different refugee camps and just trying to kind of fill in the gaps of my own identity. I'm Somali and had never been home until a few weeks ago. Conversations About Home at the Deportation Centre. Well, I think home spat me out. The blackouts and curfews like tongue against loose tooth God. Do you know how difficult it is to talk about the day your own city dragged you by the hair past the old prison, past the school gates, past the burning torsos erected on poles like flags? When I meet others like me, I recognize the missing, the longing, the memory of ash on face. No one leaves home unless home is the mouth of a shark. I've been carrying the old anthem in my mouth for so long that there's no space for another tongue or another song or another language. I know a shame that shrouds, totally engulfs. I tore up and ate my own passport in an airport hotel. I'm bloated with language I can't afford to forget. They ask me, "How did you get here? Can't you see it on my body? The Libyan desert red with immigrant bodies, the Gulf of Aden boated, the city of Rome, no jacket. I hope the journey meant more than miles because all of my children are in the water. I thought the sea was safer than the land and I want to make love, but my hair smells of war and running and running and running and I want to lay down, but these countries are like uncles who touch you when you're young and asleep. Look at all these borders foaming at the mouths with bodies broken and desperate. I'm the color of hot sun on my face. My mother's remains were never buried. I spent days and nights in the stomach of a truck. I did not come out the same. Sometimes it feels like someone else is wearing my body. I know a few things to be true. I don't know where I'm going and where I have come from is disappearing. I am unwelcome and my beauty is not beauty here. My body is burning with the shame of not belonging. My body is longing. I am the sin of memory and the absence of memory. I watch the news and my mouth becomes a sink full of blood. The lines, the forms, the people at the desks, the calling cards, immigration officers, the looks in the street, the cold settling deep into my bones, the English classes at night, the distance I am from home. But alhamdulillah, all of this is better than the scent of a woman completely on fire, or a truckload of men who look like my father, pulling out my teeth and my nails, or 14 men between my legs, or a gun, or a promise, or a lie, or his name, or his manhood in my mouth. I hear them say, "Go home." I hear them say, "Fucking immigrants, fucking refugees." Are they really this arrogant? Do they not know that stability is like a lover with a sweet mouth upon your body? One second and the next, you're just a tremor lying on the floor, covered in old currency, waiting for its return. All I can say is, I was once like you. The apathy, the pity, ungrateful placement. And now my home is the mouth of a shark. Now my home is the barrel of a gun. I'll see you on the other side. Thank you so much.